Dear students, welcome to the part 3 of the module 2 of your engineering statistics and linear algebra. Okay, so under this module name is multiple random variables. Under this module, today we shall study about two variable expectations. So once again recall which of the topics you studied in part 1 and part 2 of this module. We studied about two variables x and y, that means bivariate random variables, and we studied about writing the PDF and CDF, relationship between PDF and CDF, and obtaining the marginal densities using the bivariate densities and related problems. So recall all the topics which you have studied and remember all the formulae. Today we shall study about bivariate expectations, two variable expectations. Now, if you have a function of x and y, g of xy, in general I am giving you the definition. If you have a function of x and y, g of xy, then expectation of this function of two random variables x and y, it is given by this definition. Expectation of g of xy means it is double integral minus infinity to infinity minus infinity to infinity. This function g of xy into PDF. Bivariate PDF, fxy of x comma y dx dy. Okay, and remember, recall what was the function definition in the case of single random variable, expectation definition. If you have only a function of g of x, function of single variable g of x, then expectation of g of x was given by here only single integration minus infinity to infinity g of x into fx of x dx. Same idea we use here. Only we are extending it to two variable case. Okay, and this general formula can be used for any type of function. Even if you have only single variable here, then it is understood that second variable y is 0. In that case, this becomes only expectation of g of x, you can write. And using this definition, it is actually double integral with respect to x and y. But when you substitute for g of xy as only g of x, since it is a function of only x, if you are first evaluating the integration, if your first integration is with respect to y, then g of x can be taken out because it is a constant. So try to first integrate with respect to y. Okay, here it should be minus infinity to infinity limits. Correct this. This is minus infinity to infinity. This is a typing error. And what is this property? From the property of bivariate PDF, minus infinity to infinity, fxy of x comma y dy, it is nothing but marginal PDF. When you are integrating bivariate PDF with respect to other variable y, you get marginal PDF of x. Remember that property. So this is nothing but fx of x. Now this reduces to integration minus infinity to infinity g of x into fx of x dx. This is the formula which you have already studied in the previous module. Okay, expectation of only g of x. Similarly, you can find only expectation of g of y, meaning is same. So remember this general formula for two variable case. Correlation of x and y, we use a term called correlation. It is expected value of the product x and y. Okay, so in the place of g of xy, of your previous slide here, in the place of g of xy, take g of xy equal to x into y. You get this formula. Expectation of x into y equal to double integral minus infinity to infinity xy into the bivariate PDF fxy of x comma y dx dy. The covariance of x and y, covariance means variance of both variables x and y taken together. Okay. So if you have bivariate random variables x and y which do not have mean equal to 0, without any 0 means, then we generalize the correlation formula to define covariance. Okay. So what is the covariance? Just recall what was the formula for variance. Variance of x is given by expectation of x minus mu x whole square. Variance of x. Okay. So if you write covariance of x and y, instead of square term, you have both x and y terms here. Covariance of xy is equal to expectation of x minus mu x into y minus mu y. Okay. And if you expand this, you can multiply x minus mu x with y minus mu y using term by term multiplication. If you expand this and simplify, you will get covariance of x into y is equal to expectation of xy minus expectation of x into expectation of y. That means mu x into mu y. So I think you can understand this expansion easily. Just multiply this. Okay. X into y one term. Then mu x into y next term. Then x into minus mu y. Then minus mu x into minus mu y. So you get totally four terms. But among these four terms, first term is expectation of xy. Second term is mu x into, because mu x is a constant, being a mean, it is a constant. Mu x into only remaining expectation of y minus mu y into remaining is expectation of x plus mu x into mu y. Mu x into mu y both are constants. You can take them outside. Remaining is expectation of 1 actually. That is 1. And if you further simplify this, you can see that this expectation of y is nothing but mu y. So you get minus mu x mu y plus mu x mu y. So one mu x mu y term cancels with another mu x mu y term. So only one mu x mu y remains. So remember, covariance of x into y is given by expectation of x y minus mu x mu y. And this formula is used for the random variables without having zero means. Now, if any one random variable among these two, x and y, if any one random variable takes the value 0, then clearly either mu x is 0 or mu y is 0 means this product becomes 0. In that case, covariance reduces to expectation of xy. What was expectation of xy? It is nothing but correlation. Correlation is expectation of xy. So correlation and covariance are equal. Correlation and covariance are equal if at least one random variable has mean equal to 0. Remember this. Anyway, this you can derive yourself. Remember the general formula. Next, one example just to understand this. If y equal to minus 2x plus 3, find covariance of x into y. X comma y. Okay, in some textbooks, they also use covariance of x, y together without any comma. Don't confuse, both notations are valid. X, y you can write, or covariance of x, y can be written. X and y together without comma, you can write. Okay, so remember, covariance of x, y is given by formula. Expectation of x, y minus mu x into mu y. Simplify this. What is expectation of x into y? Y is given as minus 2x plus 3. Substitute minus, this is expectation of x into, expectation of y is given as expectation of minus 2x plus 3. Expand this further. This, when you open the bracket, you get minus 2 into x square plus 3x. And here expectation of x into, this is minus 2 into expectation of x plus 3. And from this, minus 2 can be taken out. Minus 2 into expectation of x square plus expectation of x, 3 into expectation of x, then expectation of x into minus 2 into expectation of x. You can multiply, you get minus of minus plus expectation of x whole square. Then minus expectation of x into plus 3, you get minus 3 expectation of x. You can simplify further, add the like terms together. This minus 3 expectation of x cancels with the plus 3 expectation of x. Remaining, you get only two terms. What are the terms? Minus 2 into expectation of x square plus 2 into expectation of x whole square. 2 is a common term, or minus 2 is a common term. Take out. Remaining is expectation of x square minus expectation of x whole square, which is nothing but minus 2 into variance of x. Okay, a similar result we already proved it. Okay, for variance of x, we proved a result. If y equal to minus 2x plus 3, what is the variance of x? A similar result holds here. Okay, so no need to by heart this method. Just remember the formula. Okay, when you remember the formula, when you apply the values of y given, you will get the answer. So a very simple question. So they may ask you this type of questions. Next question. Prove that covariance of ax, by is equal to ab into covariance of x, y. So how to prove this? Start from the definition of covariance. Covariance of x, y is given by expectation of xy minus expectation of x into expectation of y. Then expand this. Okay, in the place of x, if you replace by ax, and in the place of y, if you replace by by, you are going to get covariance of ax, by, which is expectation of ax into by minus expectation of ax into expectation of by. Simplify further. In this term, a and b, a into b is a common constant term. Take out, remaining is expectation of xy minus, in these two terms, from this a into expectation of x can be written, and from this term, b into expectation of y can be written. Again, a into b are constants, common terms. You can observe, a, b is a common term in both. Take out, remaining is expectation of xy minus expectation of x into expectation of y. And what is this definition? This is nothing but our covariance of xy. So covariance of ax, by is given by ab into covariance of xy. Another result. So instead of a and b, they may give you particular values. Okay, prove that covariance of 2x, 3y equal to 6 times covariance of x, y. Same meaning, here I proved with general terms. Okay, same method you have to use. If in the place of a and b, if 2 and 3 are given, a into b becomes 6. So a very simple question. Next definition, uncorrelated x and y. If covariance is 0, in that case, okay, here is 0 is given twice, just cancel this. If covariance of xy equal to 0, then we say that x and y are uncorrelated. So remember, uncorrelated means covariance is 0. What is the definition of covariance? Covariance definition is in this form, expectation of xy minus expectation of x into expectation of y. So clearly, when this is 0, these two should be equal. So you get expectation of xy is equal to mu x into mu y. So when you work out the problems, if uncorrelated x and y are given, you can equate expectation of xy with the mu x into mu y condition. So remember the definition. Which of the definitions you discussed now? We discussed expectation of bivariate random variable, then correlation, that means expectation of x into y, covariance, and uncorrelated x and y. Recall all the definitions once again. Okay. Next definition, orthogonal x and y. Orthogonal x and y means if expectation of x into y is 0, that means if correlation is 0, in that case, x and y are said to be orthogonal x and y. And in that case, what will be the value of the covariance? Covariance becomes just minus mu x into mu y. Remember, covariance of xy is equal to 0 means x and y are uncorrelated. Expectation of xy is equal to 0 means x and y are orthogonal. Remember the conditions. If x and y are independent, if x and y are independent, then what is the definition of expectation of xy? As per the definition, expectation of xy is nothing but correlation. Correlation is given by minus infinity to infinity, minus infinity to infinity, double integral, xy into bivariate PDF, fxy of dx dy. Now substitute. What if x and y are independent, then what is the condition? The bivariate PDF is equivalent to product of individual PDFs, marginal PDFs. So in the place of fxy of x, y, we can write fx of x into fy of y. Okay, now if you observe, this is a double integral, but both pair of limits are constants. You can split it as product of two single integrals. You can write one integral, you can write only function of x with the dx and limits for x. And in another integral, you can write only function of y with the dy and write the limits for y. Remember, this is possible only if your pair of limits are constants. Here anyway, you are having constant limits, minus infinity to infinity. So you can write the product. Now, if you examine each product separately, this first term is nothing but expectation of x definition, and this second term is nothing but expectation of y definition. That means, if x and y are independent, in that case, expectation of xy is equal to product of expectation of x into expectation of xy. One more result to remember. Thus, independent random variables are always uncorrelated. One result. Okay, if random variables are independent, then correlation is zero, uncorrelated. Sorry, covariance is zero. In general, expectation of x to the power n into y to the power m is equal to expectation of x to the power n into expectation of y to the power m if x and y are independent random variables. But what about the converse? But converse is true. That means if x raised to n, expectation of x raised to n into expectation of y raised to m is equal to this product, only if n and m are equal. That means general conclusions are independence implies uncorrelation, but converse need not be true. So always this converse need not be true. So if you have uncorrelated variables, you cannot say that they are independent. Remember, independent random variables are always uncorrelated. And for n equal to m, both results are true. Okay, converse part is also true. But for other values of n and m, the converse need not be true. So remember this. Correlation coefficient. The correlation coefficient denoted by rho xy is defined by rho xy equal to covariance of xy divided by sigma x sigma y. Okay, just recall the definition of correlation coefficient which you studied under mathematics. Okay, we obtained a similar formula there. Okay, correlation coefficient, there we used the notation r, here we are using rho xy. Rho xy equal to covariance of xy divided by sigma x into sigma y. And what are the properties of this correlation coefficient? As you studied under mathematics part, same property we use here. The correlation coefficient is always between minus 1 and 1. That means modulus of this rho xy will be always less than or equal to 1. And positive value of correlation coefficient implies that x tends to be large when y is large and vice versa. That means both x and y increase or decrease together. And negative value of the correlation coefficient implies that x tends to be large when y is small. That means as x increases, y decreases, or as x decreases, y increases. Okay, so they increase or decrease in the opposite directions. So remember the same properties you studied under mathematics. So remember this. Now we will work out some problems. Simple problems, you can easily understand. Bivariate PDF of two random variables x and y is given by fxy of x, y equal to 1 if x and y are in between 0 and 1. 0 less than both x and y less than 1. That means both intervals for both x and y are 0 to 1 and 0 otherwise. Show that x and y are uncorrelated. Okay. So uncorrelated means you have to show that covariance is 0. Remember, covariance definition is expectation of xy minus expectation of x into expectation of y. So remember, we need three terms now. One is expectation of xy, second one is expectation of x, and third one is expectation of y. but PDF of random variables are given. Joint PDF is given to you. So your work is to find expectation of x. We need this individual probability fx of x. So first to find fx of x. How to find individual probability from the joint probability? Recall the method. We already worked out some problems. So how to find? We integrate the bivariate PDF with respect to the other variable. So if function of x is required, we integrate with respect to y. And remember, some students are having confusion here. When you write dy here, you need to write the limits for y, not limits for x. Okay? You need to write, anyway, in this problem, both limits are same. But in some problems, when x and y limits are different, since you are integrating with respect to y, we have to write the limits for y here. Don't think that left hand side is function of x and so we have to write the limits for x. No. So with respect to which variable you are integrating, that limit has to be written here. So here limits for y, general notation is minus infinity to infinity. But as per the definition, y varies from 0 to 1. So write 0 to 1. And what is the function value? 1. Fxy of x, y is 1. Dy, integrate with respect to y. So integral of 1 is y. With respect to y, apply the limits. You get the answer 1. So here, fx of x is a constant, 1. By considering the interval of x, we can also write fx of x equal to 1 in the interval 0 to 1 and 0 otherwise. Okay. Similarly, same method, we can find the PDF of y. Fy of y, individual PDF of y, is given by integrating the bivariate CDF with respect to the other variable x. So here other variable is x. And when you are writing dx here, you need to write the limits for x. Anyway, in this problem, both limits for x and y are equal to 0 to 1. So be careful while writing the limits. Dx is written means we need to write the limits for x here. Substitute, what was the bivariate PDF value? 1. Integrate with respect to x in this interval 0 to 1. So answer is x from 0 to 1, that means equal to 1. And when this function definition is valid in this interval 0 to y. Since you are integrating with respect to x, y value remains there. So you can write the limits for y 0 to 1. So combine this, write fy of y equal to 1 from 0 to 1, 0 otherwise. So using the given bivariate PDF, we obtained individual PDFs for x and y. What was the question? Question was to show that x and y are uncorrelated. So we need expectation of xy, expectation of x and expectation of y. So we obtained only individual PDFs now. Find means of individual variables. What is mean of x, mu x? It is given by minus infinity to infinity x into fx of x dx. Integrate this. Fx of x just now you obtained as 1 in this interval 0 to 1. X integrate. Apply the limits. You get the answer half. Since it is a very simple integration, I am not explaining this. Same method. Find expectation of y. You know the definition of expectation of y. Integration of y into PDF. Fy of y. And your PDF value is 1. So only you are integrating y into 1 now. Y into 1 dx. Integrate. You get okay. This should be integration with respect to y. Please correct this. Typing error. This should be dy. Here also dy. Correct this. So when you integrate with respect to y, you get the answer. Y square by 2. Between the limits 0 and 1. Answer is 1 by 2. So just correct this. This should be dy. Integration is with respect to y. Now, how to find expectation of x into y? Here both variables are present. So you need to use the definition of correlation. Expectation of x into y definition is given by this. Double integration of xy into fxy of dx dy. Fxy dx dy. Substitute. Xy into your fxy of x comma y answer is 1. So only you get x into y dx dy. Since both limits are constants here, you can also separate the integrals and write it as product of two integrals. Anyway, here I used direct integration. I first integrated with respect to inner variable x, y is a constant, integral of x is x square by 2, apply the limits for x 0 to 1, then you get answer as 1 by 2 into, this is 1 by 2 into y. So 1 by 2 is constant, take out, integral of y is again y square by 2, apply the limit, again you get 1 by 2. Okay, I have not shown every step since it is a very simple integral. So answer will be 1 by 4. Now check whether expectation of xy and expectation of x into expectation of y, both answers are equal. Yes, expectation of xy you got it as 1 by 4 and mu x into mu y you got 1 by 2 into 1 by 2 which is 1 by 4. That means covariance of xy is equal to expectation of xy minus mu x into mu y, answer is 0. When covariance of x and y are equal to 0, we say that x and y are uncorrelated. So we proved that x and y are uncorrelated. So very simple question. Next question. Given sigma x equal to 1, sigma square x equal to 2, mu y equal to 3, sigma square y equal to 4, and rho xy is the notation for the correlation coefficient. It is 0.5. So these data values are given. Find the covariance and correlation. Determine A and B if the transformation Y is given by AX plus B. Okay. So recall, what is the definition of correlation coefficient? Rho XY equal to covariance of XY by sigma X into sigma Y. What is the formula for covariance of XY? Here rho XY is given. Rho XY is given. Sigma X is given. Sigma square X is given. You can find square root of this. And sigma y is given. So this is given, this is given, and left hand side is given. So remaining is only unknown term, covariance of xy. So rearrange the terms in this equation. You get covariance of xy equal to rho xy into sigma x into sigma y. Substitute. All the three terms are given to you. Multiply and you get the answer 1.4142. Next question, correlation. What is the formula for correlation? Covariance formula is expectation of xy minus mu x mu y. But in this case, covariance is known. Mu x and mu y are known. So how to find expectation of xy? Correlation. Substitute. Get the answer. Correlation equal to 4.4142. Okay, just verify this. Don't just watch the video, write everything in your notes and try to understand. Okay. Now you obtained covariance and correlation. Next question. Determine A and B if y equal to AX plus B. So start from the given transformation. Already we proved this result in the previous module. If y is AX plus B, then variance of y, sigma square y, is given by A square into sigma square x, a coefficient of x is a, square of that into sigma square of x. And sigma square of x and sigma square of y are given to you, substitute. This is 4 and this is 2. When you simplify this, you get a equal to root 2. So you got the value of a. Now use the formula for the mean. What is mean of y? Mean of y is given by mu y equal to a into mu x plus b. But a is root 2, substitute, a is root 2, mu x is 1, plus b is unknown. Rearrange the terms in this, you will get b equal to 1.585. And substitute in your linear transformation, therefore your transformation is y equal to x plus b, that means root 2x plus 1.585. Or only a and b values you can write like this. You got a equal to root 2 and b equal to 1.585. A similar question, slightly different. The mean and variance of random variable x are minus 2 and 3. Mean and variance of y are 3 and 5. Correlation is expectation of xy equal to minus 8.7. What are the covariance COV of xy and correlation coefficient rho xy? Again, two questions are asked, covariance and correlation. So which are the given terms? First, list them. mean and variance of x are given. So mean is minus 2 and variance means sigma square x, which is 3. Mean and variance of y are given as 3 and 5. So mu y is 3, sigma square y is 5. Correlation, expectation of xy is minus 8.7. Okay. So find covariance. For covariance, you have the direct formula. Covariance of xy is given by expectation of xy minus mu x mu y, which is minus 8.7. Answer is given. And mu x and mu y are given. It is a direct question. Only you have to remember this formula. Substitute and calculate. You get minus 2.7. And what is the formula for correlation coefficient? Correlation coefficient is given by covariance of xy divided by sigma x sigma y. Substitute. Now covariance of xy is known. Sigma x and sigma y are square roots of the variances. Variance of x is 3. That means sigma x is square root of 3. Variance of y is 5. So sigma y is square root of 5. Substitute and calculate. A very simple question and direct question. Okay, only you have to remember these formulae, covariance formula and correlation coefficient formula. I will stop here. In the next session, we will continue with some more problems and some more topics under bivariate random variables. Thank you.